what it is. Yo, we gonna keep it all the way 5,000. I don't know about these other dudes. They keep it a buck. We keep it 5 G's. Everything 5. What? Now check it, Casanova. 2 times, huh? 2 times Casanova. Brooklyn. That's where I'm from, born and raised. Right now, I'm in Southside. Cause I come out here for some moves. But without further ado, we're gonna get into this Casanova shit, right? We gonna act like if your boy, what's his name? What up, player? Your boy, Hassan didn't say a few days ago, not even a week ago, I think. Yo, next is Casanova. He gonna get indicted. That's why he was screaming, right? And then he's like, because we gonna act like the feds don't know that he's supplying the whole Brooklyn. Some shit like that. If you remember, leave it in the comments. Facts, if you saw that. Oh, I'm bugging out. Yo, boy, you bugging. You on K-27. Boom. But yo, that's a fact. And ain't nobody say nothing about that. You know why? Because dudes ain't listening right. We listen to what we want to hear, you heard? Like the super drama shit, right? I pay attention real good, you heard? To be aware is to be alive. Some of us act like we aware and we walking around with blinders and earplugs on and can't hear shit right. But immediately after that report, the feds are like, yo, the homeboy's getting snatched up. Boom. I won't be surprised if they use Hassan Campbell's video at trial. Right? Because what are we going to say? Oh, this for entertainment only. Bro, dudes got to watch what they say on YouTube. And I'm not saying that it's super facts that it was because of what Hassan said. But the feds and the police do watch these videos. They don't need to go outside now to get a case. They could put a whole indictment together just over social media and YouTube. Facts. It's been happening. The only thing that not all the time they scream out, oh, this is going down because of the YouTube video we saw. You feel me? But they pick up info like that, bro. That's a fact. So they log in, see that, hear that, and I'm like, holy snap. And you know how it goes like this, bro. They so grimy that all they gotta do, once they know you've been on parole and you've been arrested before and all that, instead of like, yo, he already did time, you know what I'm saying? Like, let me let him be. I could destroy his whole life with one little thing, even with their lives, right? Because we all know that the feds, regular police, anybody that's in law enforcement, they the best liars in the world. Because in court, in trial, it's about who could tell the best lie. Who's gonna be more believable? Who's a good actor? Anybody that's been on trial and beat it is a super good actor, bro. Because they could lie real good. Facts, to where you have other people come in, a jury.
Yes, I do.
Of your peers, supposedly. It's never that. And you convince them, bro. You feel me? You the man or you the woman. So right now with Casanova, it's gonna be like, who could tell the best lie? Yo, you ever see police, they pull you over, boom, a bunch of y'all in the car. This is facts. And we're gonna get back to Casanova. They pull you over, they be like, you ever been arrested? Nah, that's your man's, you know, right? Nah, never been arrested. You sure? Nah, bro. Boom, right? They definitely not taking your word for that. They're like, ah, you fucking piece of shit liar. Hey, Bob, run this guy's fucking name. Some dude saying he's never been arrested. You see the way he's fucking dressed? Because they judge you immediately, right? Like, if you even look like you part of our culture, mine's and yours, right? Because hip-hop is everybody's culture. It's not one group of people culture. Facts. I'm Puerto Rock, so You already know. We together with blacks, with no cap, no disrespect. You know, made that hip-hop shit pop. And everybody else put their little bits and grains into it, made it what it is. But they'll be like, yo, what about you? Yeah, for what? For robbery or whatever. All right, you step right here. You definitely gotta step to the side immediately. And then their main focus is on you, on destroying the rest of your life, bro. Like trying to make sure you never get out again, right? And I guess that it makes them look good, like in their record, like to becoming a detective or moving up in the ranks, that should be barred. That's wrong, because that makes them go hard. That makes them set people up and everything. If I know that the way for me to go up in the ranks is behind putting people away for a lot of years, the more years I put them away for, the more props I get. That shit is wrong. Super wrong. But ain't nobody saying nothing about that. Because we don't think about that. We don't think that deep. And it's deeper than all this shit. Right now, people should be making noise. Talk to Cass, be like, yo, bro, you really ain't had nothing to do with this shit, bro. Don't lie to me. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm going to help you hard, but you got to tell me the truth. Like, and hopefully it'll be a non-telling-ass motherfucker, right? And once he says, nah, Brian had nothing to do with that. Because I'm pretty sure he didn't have nothing to do with it to a major scale where it's like racketeering, fucking fraudulent, like all types of shit. You probably knew them, and what they're going to use is that you knowingly and knowledgeably, you know, whatever the fuck, had knowledge of what was going on, and you didn't call the cops. And what people fail to realize in this world is when you're hanging out with dudes and he tells you what he's doing, or you even see what he's doing, or you got an idea what he's doing, when you don't report it to the fucking police, if they want to, it's a charge, my dude. You was there, you saw it, you didn't tell nobody. It's a charge. So the best thing to do is stay away from these motherfuckers that's doing all these crazy crimes if you already made it. And it's fucked up because it's like separating people that might need a little help from people that are super rich. But it's like you gotta love your peoples from a distance. When dudes be like, oh, they changed, they got bougie, right, or whatever. They made it and they left. They left niggas in the mud. Bro, they can't take everybody with them. And I understand that now, and I ain't got shit. You know what I'm saying? Because that's another thing. Everybody fronts on social media like they rich. So the feds are going to treat you like you rich. And be like, I know he got to be doing something wrong. They try to find anything when they want to, bro. It'll be bud, anything. Dudes be like, yo, it's only bud. Yeah, all right, but it's a lot of bud, nigga. And this New York, that shit ain't fully legal. You feel me? But another thing is that a lot of times the police don't even know about dudes. Like, oh, he's a head, let's say. And I'm not saying Casanova is, because I don't know his business. You know what I'm saying? Even though I know what's going on, I don't know his full business. I don't give a fuck. You know, and even if I did, I'm not going to say that on here, because, and it's not because of the feds, because it's just like saying that I know right now. Like, they pick up on anything you try to hide, bro. But that's what kills me, that dudes act like if he didn't just say that, bro. That shit is crazy. But now everybody's making videos about it. Yo, Casanova, damn, bro. You know, and I said, I'm gonna make a video when it calms down a little bit, because I don't like to make it like I did it for clout. I'm trying to tell the people a message, right? And it has nothing to do with views with me, subscribers and all that. But if you feel like subscribing, you already know, hit that little cling cling, bing bing, and ling ling, and get down with the lockout gang. I gotta stop saying lockout gang too. I'm gonna keep it lockout fam, because I might get indicted. Members of the lockout gang, a YouTube monster oriented ex-member of the Lion Kings, or member of the Lion Kings, you know, because they like to call you ex right away. They try to get you killed by your own peoples. Like, bro, you was denying it to the police, and now your peoples are so dumb, all these so-called gangsters, that they be like, yo, you was denying it? Bro, it's the feds. It's the police. They got it in record already. But you supposed to go there, and when they say, oh, you a gang member? Yeah, sir, of course. Yeah, I'm the head leader of the gang. I'm an OG, bro. I've been in that shit for, bro, since it damn near started, bro. As a matter of fact, I was there with the dude. Like, yo, these dudes are crazy. And they quick to air you out. Right now, dudes like Casanova, and God bless him, get locked up. The first people that want beef with him, it's not even other gang members you got to worry about. It's your own people. Like, oh, you was repping Gorilla, or we this. Boo, boo, boo. And it's lit all over the building. That's crazy. They do it. We do it. Everybody do it. It is stupid. And you violate as a bro. You pound out another bro. You did something dirty to him. Homie, you didn't rob his mother. You know, commit a rape or some shit. Like, everything is forgivable, bro. That's your brother. You know why things don't happen with certain dudes that are in cliques? Like, he'd be like, nothing, I never did nothing. Me and another bro never had beef. Me and another homie never had beef. You know why? Because you don't be around them like that. Because if you were super active and you even been around them for a few years, shit is going to happen. Just like with your real brother in your house, with your moms, you and the little dude live together, and it pops, things happen. Boo, boo, mommy! You know what I'm saying? Jamal's hit me! Boy, you better stop it! You know what I mean? Like, peep, pop, boom, pop! Mom, dude, whip both of ya. Shit is gonna happen if you active around your bros all the time. But as the OGs, as the dude that's running this shit, I would be like, what happened? All right, well, you're not supposed to be doing that anyway together. Well, that had to do with drugs or whatever. Y'all ain't supposed, technically all these gangs, cliques, nations, whatever, ain't supposed to be selling drugs, bro. More or less with your own bro, like giving them drugs to sell. Y'all both in violation. So shut the fuck up. You feel me? Because this is an upliftment of the people. And how the fuck you uplifting the people if you're giving your brother a brick to sell on the block because he's broke? Nigga, tell them where they hiring. Show him how to start a fucking Twitch or YouTube channel, anything, bro. There's an audience for everything. You could be, like I said the other day, you could be the type of dude that pick your boogers and put them in your ear. And there's a million motherfuckers in the world that pick their boogers and put it in their ear, believe it or not. Look it up. Google it. Yo, we gonna have mad booger in the ear channels now. Yo, great idea, Ward. You gotta stand out. You gotta do something that you stand out from the rest. And the rest is history. Right now, Casanova stood out from the rest. Because they looking for him for probably something he had nothing to do with. That's sad, bro. Because they figure he got the money, he got the power and all that. He probably, I hope not, was there or he was seen somewhere in camera, and that shit is a wrap. Meanwhile, he didn't even know what was going on. So where all these rappers now, all these activists, all these YouTubers, everybody that says, I got love for Cas, step, make noise, step to the feds, protest about this shit. Like, yo, you can't keep snatching up our brothers that are fucking doing well, that are ex-gang members, and even if they still involved, they the positive ones, bro. They made a change in their life, and they set an example for our people. Why are you taking him? Why are you making the story end up wrong? Like, yo, he wasn't doing good. He was grimy. He was getting 15-year-old kids shot. Bro, he didn't literally shoot that kid himself. And you think, I don't believe that he would send a 15-year-old kid to get shot. And if you do, then you wasn't even a real fan like that. So stop it. Right? And there's times that people blow trial for shit they didn't even do. So don't get that twisted either. Like, oh man, he did it. He blew trial. People blow trial every day for something they had nothing to do with. Facts. But where are the people now? Make noise about that. Because they're going to start snatching more dudes. If y'all let them get away with this. Like, yo, you a gang member? Okay, you wealthy? All right, it's your fault. You feel me? You be around them still, you getting indicted. And they're going to set an example that if you want to rap, that gang shit is not the wave. So dead that. And that's how they're going to combat crime, they believe, and these deaths. But that's not the way to go. Because it's going to become a new way of getting rid of our good brothers that are setting an example that I can make it out the hood, so could you. Don't let that happen, man. Facts. Love all people. You already know what this is. This is not over. I'm just in a little rush because I got to go to the Bronx right now. Look, I ain't even fronting. I'm taking the train. Boop, hold up. You see it? With the damn bus on a block. I don't know if you see the MTA shit. Anyway, I'm going over there. Facts. To the BX. You already know Yankee Stadium. War travel, boy. I be in every borough. Facts. After that, I may have to go to Brooklyn. We stay on the Iron Horse. No car. And we could go in car, motorcycle, moped, anything. I get on a fucking 10-speed on the highway. Facts. Violate all the rules. Now, don't do that, guys. But you already know what it is, man. It's on the lock. Our warpath. We coming with a lot of content. Just my computer broke. So if you feel like you want to help out to get a new computer, everybody else did it. And they have major, supposedly big channels, right? Because you guys see a dude with 500,000 subs and, oh, his channel's big. Subscribers and views don't equal money and don't mean people are watching. Watch time means people are watching. But check us out on Spotify, iHeartRadio, Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, Overcast, every major audio podcast streaming platform in the world. We there. Facts. On the lock. I love y'all. Y'all already know I'm from Brooklyn, but this is Jamaica, Queens. Gang shit.